You're at the Business Insurance Zone with me, Steve Savant, syndicated financial columnist and contributor to Backroom Technician. This week on the Biz Disability Insurance for Individuals series and our tribute to Disability Awareness Month of May 2013. And on today's show, Long-Term Disability Insurance with Marcy Pruitt.
When it comes to life insurance, annuities, long-term care, disability, or group pension plans, we're the news you can use.
Well, welcome everyone to the Business Insurance Zone. I'm your host, Steve Savant, and we're broadcasting to a nationwide audience of financial advisors right here in Fountain Hills, Arizona, home of America's largest fountain. And I want you to visit it sometime when you come out here. We'll show you the studio and the fountain. And with me today, day four, the disability diva herself, Miss March Madness. That DI show was great. Marcy Pruitt. Hey, Marcy.
Hi, Steve. Thank you.
That was a great show. Was that
I
fun to do
it.
That?
That was fun.
Did you like the background
Georgia
of the Georgia
was awesome.
Dome? It was awesome. It was awesome. And people are like, Steve, are you guys really at the Georgia Dome? Well, okay, confession time. We were virtually at the Georgia. We're just, the green screen's a wonderful technology. Let's just say that. Today we're talking about, the reason we talked about short-term yesterday is because we really want you to leave the table with a policy. Mm-hmm. You know, we want you to actually sell something because sometimes people get spooked by long commitments, big numbers, big premium commitments, whatever. I say it's not really that way, but sometimes the perception is greater than reality. But today we're going to talk about Marcy's wheelhouse, long-term for individuals, to throw in a little ONOC again. We kind of talked about this at the end of Tuesday's show. I want to talk about this, and thinking about Tuesday's show or any of the shows you've missed, if you've missed, go out to our site. I highly recommend you watch it in sequence, in chronology, so you can have a good learning experience. So hop out to our site, thebiz.tv, and watch Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday show before you watch today's show. Mm-hmm. But if you're here watching it anyways, welcome to our show. And Marcy, we're talking about long-term DI. Now, we want to talk about, I'm a high-powered employee of a firm. And they want to capture me and recruit me. And DI is a huge come hither benefit. I mean, it is.
Absolutely.
And on top of it, the company could, we're going to get into this next week with DI Dan, but really, I could get more because I could get it deducted, right? I mean, from a company point of view.
Absolutely.
So there's a couple ways to go. Let's talk about that.
Okay. Well, it's absolutely a recruiting tool to attract mm-hmm. and attract and retain key employees. It is something that you can carve out and legally discriminate in favor of highly compensated employees, which there's very few products and things that companies can do anymore in that vein without discrimination testing. So the ability to fully insure a highly compensated executive's income, that's a draw. Mm-hmm. I mean, health insurance is the largest percentage of payroll as a rule for employers paying for benefits. And then other, dental and other products, they're dollars in, dollar out. The ability to protect mm-hmm. your income is so important because that is your single largest asset, mm-hmm. your ability to earn an income.
I think if you're looking at today's exec packages, you have the rainmakers in the company.
Right.
You have the people that are actually the operational people that are really running the show. You want to take care of the people that are really key components of your company. And when I'm thinking about DI as a recruiting tool and a retention tool, remember, it's
Correct.
Not just I got the, now right. I want to maintain that. Because remember, especially today, oddly enough, even with the high unemployment that the United States is experiencing, the headhunters are everywhere lately. They're all over trying to go after great people mm-hmm. in good companies. And one of the big, and I mean centerpiece benefits is DI. Now, I'm always yin and yang about this. Should I deduct it and get the bigger number, or should I have it come tax-free?
Well, it should be tax-free. We like to see that. Group is usually taxable. Mm-hmm. So you're already going to, if you have group, and most mm-hmm. of the larger employers do, a larger percentage of large companies, meaning 100 or more lives, have some form of group LTD.
It's short LTD, isn't it, though? Or no, it could be long.
It could be long, long-term to 65. But the highly compensated are reversely discriminated against because there's caps. There's usually not incentive compensation mm-hmm. covered. It's taxable. It's offset against Social Security. So the highly compensated, if you have a $6,000 monthly cap on your group LTD plan and you're making over $100,000, you're not covered at 60%. Mm-hmm. So we like to see the individual tax-free. Even if the employer pays the premium, they can gross it up, as you know, which would then, it's cheaper to pay tax on the premium than to pay tax on the benefit when you're disabled.
Mm-hmm. When I'm thinking of going in and looking at the highly compensated, the executive packaging, or maybe I'm just a solo, does this work for people who own their own company, are 100% owners, whether it's an S corp or an LLC, I'm the owner, should I put something on myself and should I run it through the company or no, I should keep it separate?
Well, for a sub S or a partnership or sole proprietor, it's really not a deduction, and that's an IRS regulation. So it's not going to be a tax deduction, therefore it will always be a tax-free benefit. Mm-hmm. But there's ways to find the money, and when we talk about consulting your accountant or whatnot, legal advice, you can manipulate or recharacterize your W-2 wages versus your distribution.
I love
find the money.
You gave me two words there. Manipulate was not as good a compliance word, but I love recharacterization.
Okay.
I think that was Marcy was just testing you in your audience. Thank you for recharacterization, yes. Yeah, well, I'm always
and
looking for...
And seek counsel.
Yes, and don't forget, I'll be saying that after the commercial. Always seek your... don't listen to
tax
our tax
advice.
We don't give tax advice in the show, do we?
That's right.
We just tell you it could or could not be. So when I'm building my long-term care, and we talked about ONOC, you know, whether we have to find out should we look at that or not? And we'll have to find out the duties and things that you've talked about.
Right.
But when we talk about long-term disability, then, I mean, we're talking about all the bells and whistles. Am I throwing residual on that?
Absolutely.
Am I throwing the cost of living? There's a lot of things we're building out a product that's going to last us, a long time.
Well, and back to the comment of the individuals, the business owners, you absolutely, under qualified sick pay plan arrangements, you want to have a plan in writing or fund it with a disability, because if you plan to pay yourself wages when you're disabled without a plan, then tax consequences come into play.
So you need besides the policy, if I'm hearing correctly, you actually need a written filed document that says all that.
Well, yes, a corporate resolution, very simple.
Wow. When we come back from the break, we're going to continue our whole discussion on long-term disability, part of our disability insurance series with Marcy Pruitt. And don't forget to enroll at IULuniversity.com for the best training, education, and sales support when it comes to life insurance for retirement income.
You're listening to the insurance industry's number one resource for products, planning ideas, carrier information, and interviews you can use. When it comes to life insurance, annuities, long-term care, disability, or group pension plans, we're the news you can use.
Did you know the average 401k runs out of money just 7 to 8 years into retirement? Time Magazine, The Wall Street Journal, and many other publications have warned of the difficulty of saving with a 401k. But what if there was a way to create tax-free lifetime retirement income with no stock market risk? Good news, there is.
You know, living in fear of the next market dive is not the way I want to live my life.
Why would I go out there and take on risk when I don't need to?
I have a lot less stress knowing I can't lose any more of my retirement savings in the stock market.
Call now to receive your free, no-obligation analysis of what this retirement vehicle could do for you, a comparison to your current retirement plan, and a free video that explains this exciting opportunity. Start planning a retirement you can enjoy instead of worrying about future tax increases and stock market losses. Creating income that will last your entire life is the most important thing you'll ever do. Take control of your future. Call now for your free analysis, comparison, and video.
Well, welcome back to the Business Insurance Zone. I'm Steve Savant with Marcy Pruitt. And remember, you can order today's materials at thebiz.tv. And while you're out there, go on the top of the menu bar and hit BizBlog. And you'll click on it. You'll see that big backroom technician icon for your 30-day free trial. Please do it. You will fall in love with it like I do. I've been using it for 22 years. It's a great needs analysis sales support material for financial planning you'll ever use. And if you decide to buy it, I think it's like $50 a month. It's golden. Before making any other discussions, because we did talk about a few tax things, and Marcy was only kidding about the manipulation. Recharacterization is the cool MBA word. Always check in with your tax advisor and your broker-dealer, compliance department, and you're not security licensed, are you?
No.
Thank God for that, okay? Okay, we're talking about long-term care disability, part of our disability series with Marcy. And Marcy is one of the leading authorities in the country on DI. You've been in this really a long time.
I mean, I started early, but almost 30 years.
Oh my gosh. I mean, you must have been a teenager when you did. When we're talking about long-term, we were talking about things like how important is, you know, we talked about it as an introduction, but I want to talk a little bit about these riders now.
Okay.
Residual. How important for a white-collar exec is residual? Because I see people blowing this off sometimes.
Right.
So talk about it.
I think residual, you know, again, statistically, probably 80% of the claims are residual in nature, because right. you can have residual, there'll be a crossover, whether you start your claim as a total disability and you recover and come back, or you start your claim as a residual and it's debilitating and you become total. So there's mm-hmm. usually coming in or out of the claim, there's some form of partial slash residual benefit that could be paid.
Now, when I think about this, what kind of, why would people not do this? Because is it really a big expensive rider to do this or no?
Not really, but no, I would absolutely do that over an inflation or some of the other sizzle and bells and whistle.
So if you get into where you load up a Cadillac type plan and then you have to start paring back, that's not one of your first parebacks.
No, absolutely not.
Okay, so that's an important one in your mind.
Right, especially if you're fee for service mm-hmm. and you're seeing less clients, patients, you know, tax accounting, mm-hmm. you know, whatever it is. If you're fee for service, if you're generating revenue and you're not, and because of your lost time or duties, you're losing income, you need residual.
Now, when I'm thinking about residual, because that's an important piece of the pie, does it depend on my age? Because now, right now, what are you using for your COLI and or inflation rider? What's that number you guys are generally using for inflation?
From the percentage of premium or age?
Oh, no, I'm talking about the actual inflation. Are you using 2% inflation?
Oh, I'm sorry,
4%?
Yes. Typically 3%. Tied to the consumer pricing index increase or a flat 3%. Some will go to 6 or 7, but we haven't seen inflation like that in, you know, almost since Reagan mm-hmm. years. So the 3% compounded is a good number, right? That's
okay.
a good number.
So if I do that, and I might want to do that just because you want your DI to kind of go with you, you're getting raises, you're getting maybe
right.
your performance bonuses, whatever, right? Incorporated into your base. That brings up another question. I'm just curious. You know, we went ahead and we did this DI based on our base salary or our total salary of the last how many years? When I'm looking to right. do this, am I just doing my base or I'm doing it all in? And how far back do I look on my 1040?
Well, carriers will want to look at 2 to 3 years if incentive compensation. Mm-hmm. If you're a W-2 or contract guarantee, then we'll look at that year. Otherwise, the difference again of group versus individual, we want the total compensation, incentive comp, commission,
all
bonus,
in.
All in.
Now, if I do that, I'm going to have to go back at least 24 months
right.
with my 1040 that's going to have to reflect that.
With all schedules, correct.
Okay. Now, do you find people, is that pretty easy to get your, everybody, when you request 1040s, everybody's okay with that?
I think so. Today, most of our tax returns are sent on a disk or electronically mm-hmm. anyway. Many agents are working with their, mm-hmm. other finances and their CPAs or whatnot, and so it's attainable. But that's one of the first questions you want to ask, because mm-hmm. especially if you're a sole proprietor, we look at your Schedule C. So you do need to disclose financial underwriting. So you're really wasting your time. Find out, you want to get a look at those tax returns up mm-hmm. front, because at the end of the day, that medical is very easy to obtain with MIB mm-hmm. and
sure.
you know, the testing we do and records and script check, but the financial side of it is really what we're underwriting, because that's what we're underwriting, your ability to earn the income.
Okay, so this is what I just heard, because I think this is kind of in reverse from a mortality merchant, a mercenary that I am.
Mm-hmm.
I really want to look at my 1040s first to really quantify what benefit I'm going to try to carve out based on my income. Get that done first before I even start looking at the medical, because a lot of people, I think, they just punt. They're used to, I'm just going to write my medical. I'm going to go to the MIB. They're going to check my scripts.
Right.
I'm going to have my urine and blood taken. Done.
Right.
Order the APSs. Done. But actually, that could have been shot down if we would have seen the 1040. We did all this work for nothing.
Exactly.
So this is one of those times in morbidity land where we do reverse. We're doing financial justification. We're looking at those numbers first to actually design our long-term DI.
Right. Well, and when you look at the exposure to a carrier, I mean, a 35-year-old that makes $100,000 a year, there's potentially $3 million of earnings to age retirement that mm-hmm. we're covering. So what would a bank require if you're financing a home mm-hmm. for $3 million? You know, we need to see the financials.
When I think about the human value, and I have this, if you guys want to see this, this will actually calculate your total worth as an earner all in. And I mean, let's say you're 35, 45. I'm looking at this one here. This is a calculator that we'll send you. Again, just order it at thebiz.tv. Mm-hmm. This calculates at this person a little older, that their total human life value as an earner, I'm not trying to put life of value on a person, but not net worth statement, but their actual earning ability is sitting at 1.9 million left. Now, this isn't mine, in case somebody's wondering if it's Steve's. I wish it was. But as you get older and you see, here's the number, this person here is about 50-something, and they're saying, that's my actual human value all in for my earning potential. And we're talking about 2.5% to protect $2.1 million. Remember, you can watch all our shows this week on DI by going out to our website, thebiz.tv, and follow me on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Pinterest, and Google+. That's the buzz on the biz for today. You've been in the zone, the business insurance zone.
You're listening to the insurance industry's number one resource for products, planning ideas, carrier information, and interviews you can use. When it comes to life insurance, annuities, long-term care, disability, or group pension plans, we're the news you can use.